Hi friends, welcome to today's video. Today we are going to explore the topic of VPN. So if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button so that you will get the latest update delivered first to you. So let's start with today's class. So we are going to study VPN. VPN stands for Virtual Private Network. Okay, so the important term here is that it is a virtual network. Okay, we'll try to understand what this virtual means, and this is a private network. Okay, so let's understand this first, private network, and then we will understand about the virtual part. So suppose you are in an office. Okay, so office has a Wi-Fi, which is your router, and you connect with your office with the laptop and also with the mobile. Okay, and there is a printer which is also connected to this router. So using your mobile or laptop, you can give the instruction to the printer that print this document, and it will print. Okay, so these are connected together, and this is called your private network. Okay, it is a network because various devices can communicate with each other, and this is private because only people who are connected with this router in the office can have access to the printer. Okay, so now suppose that you have to work from home. Okay, and you have to give a command for print. Okay, so how we can do? You can call your friend and tell him that I have sent you an email, get that email and print this. Okay, but suppose this data is sensitive and you want to for example give the print instruction and tell someone to pick it, for example HR team, who cannot for example print on your behalf. So how can you solve this problem? Okay, so in the private network, people in the network which are actually connected to the router has only access to the resources in this network. But if you are working from home or remote, if you want to communicate with the printer, you'll have to connect to this network. Okay, so one way to do that will be that this printer, you can put it in the on the internet. Okay, using the public IP of the router, you can allow the public request to come to this IP address, local IP address. Okay, it means that this printer will be available on the internet, but this will not be secure because anybody can use your printer. Okay, so in order to solve this problem, what we have to do is that we want to create this network which is private, and also a person who is outside this network should be able to access this network privately. Okay, so here the VPN comes into play. So in order to design this system, we'll have a VPN server. Okay, we'll understand what VPN server actually does in further in the video. So for now, we have got a VPN server. Okay, so your network will be connected to VPN server. For example, your router could be connected to the VPN server or devices. Now you can connect to this VPN server from your home or anywhere, and it will act like you are in this network. Okay, so VPN network extend your local network so that you can access it locally but on the public internet. Okay, so here we will have to think about the security and how actually you are able to communicate on this VPN, using this VPN server securely. We'll understand that. Okay, there is one more use case of VPN which is for the consumer perspective. Okay, this is very widely used. Generally VPN people understand in this term only. So here what happens is that you take a VPN service. Okay, there is various service providers which provide you the VPN connections. So as a customer, you take their service, you subscribe to their service, they provide you with the username and password. Okay, username and password. Using this username and password, you connect to the VPN server anywhere in the world. For example, in servers in different countries, you connect with one of the servers and then you access the internet. Okay, what is the advantage of this? Okay, suppose this VPN server is not there, so you can connect directly to the internet. Okay, so when you are connecting to the internet, you are using some ISP, internet service provider. Okay, some companies, internet service company, you are using their services. So whatever you are accessing, for example, you are accessing site A, okay, and you are sending the data over this ISP. Okay, so this ISP knows where you are accessing the internet. Okay, suppose you are in some country where access to some site is restricted, so ISP can block this site, so you won't be able to access this site. Okay, or for example, you want to hide your identity for some security purpose. If you will communicate over the ISP, ISP will be able to know that who you are, basically where you live, based on your subscription. You are provided with your IP address on this system by the ISP, so they know that where you are and what you are accessing. Okay, so many times government regulates and it asks for the ISP to give the identity of the people who are doing certain things on the internet. So all these use cases are there where you would want that your ISP should not know that what you are doing. So in that case, you can take the subscription of some VPN service. VPN service, what it does, it installs the same VPN servers around the world, okay, on your behalf. And you have got VPN client, we'll understand it further. VPN client software runs on your laptop or your mobile, and this connects to the VPN server, and from here you can access the internet. So ISP would not know that who you are and what you are doing on the internet. Okay, this shields the identity. Also, the communication with the VPN is encrypted. Okay, so somebody is trying to, for example, intercept in between and read the packets, he would not be able to because this is encrypted, we'll understand it. So this is the basic use case, two major use case where VPN comes into play. One, when we want to extend your local network so that it can be accessed securely, just like somebody is accessing within the office but from the internet, public internet. Other, you want to shield your identity, you can use some VPN service provider and access the internet. Though there will be a problem here, few things. For example, your network connectivity will be slower because it is going through their VPN servers, not directly. Okay, so these things will come, but this provides identity shielding. Now with these two use cases, will really understand that how VPN actually works, and that is something which made me curious, that how it can make this for example this private network act like a private network over the internet. Okay, this is the interesting part, so we'll understand it now. VPN makes your private network extend into your public network. So this is done by a concept which we'll understand. So again, the same example, you have your office and there is a VPN server inside the office, or you are using some third party VPN server, and as a user you can connect to the office just like you were in the office using a software running in your software or mobile, that is a VPN client. Okay, so how does this happen, that you are able to connect with the office, that is local area network, from the internet, and this connection appears like the secure connection. Okay, so let's understand. Suppose this was a printer, okay, and this printer has a local IP address assigned to it on this network. Okay, you are here, you are at home for example, and your home router assigns a local IP address to you. Now suppose you want to send information, suppose printer is sending some information to you. Okay, some information that it has printed. So what happens is that the message is first sent to the VPN server. Okay, VPN server, here the message will be we will understand it, what it happens, it is called encapsulation and encryption. So message will be encrypted and encapsulated, and it will be sent over the internet, and finally your VPN client software will receive that, and then it will deliver that message to you. So over the internet it appears like a tunnel, okay? So it makes a tunnel. So actually this makes the connection secure, so that's why we are calling it as a tunnel. From this point, for example this point B to this point C, we are sending information which is encapsulated and encrypted. So it appears like from point B to point C there is a tunnel, and if anybody tries to, for example, dig into this tunnel and get your packets that you have sent, then he will not be able to understand the message because it is encrypted, okay? So this encryption and encapsulation makes it appear like you are communicating in a secure tunnel. So your office network is now connected to you via this tunnel, okay? So what is this tunnel, we'll have to understand, okay? So let's see. So connection is made via tunneling protocol. Whenever you send information over the internet, it is done with the help of TCP/IP mostly. So when you send, you have packets of data, okay? The packets of the data has got headers that has information where it has to go and the content also, okay? So this packet is sent over the network and the routers move this packet and finally it reaches to us, okay? What VPN does, it uses a protocol which is called tunneling protocol, okay? When you are sending information from your local network to another local network, what happens is that you are sending information, for example, to this local IP, from this local IP, okay, as you will do in the LAN. Now this message packet cannot be delivered to it because it has to move through the internet, it has to have a public IP. So what happens that in tunneling protocol there is something called encapsulation, okay? So this packet that has the original location locally is wrapped, okay? It is wrapped at the VPN server's end, okay? And when it is wrapped, it is provided the standard headers and the content which this internet can use, okay, based on TCP/IP, for example. So this in packet is the new packet which encapsulates your original messages, okay? And this message which is inside it, it is also encrypted, okay? So now this packet which was supposed to move locally without, by encapsulation, it can now move over the internet, okay? So this is the role of a tunnel. It provides the additional protocol over the standard TCP/IP or other standard internet protocols, okay? So this tunnel protocol encapsulates this and encrypt this message so that it can move over the internet securely, and finally at the end of VPN client software running at your end will be able to take out the message and decrypt the message and finally deliver to the place where it has to go, okay? So this is how a VPN works. Now in order to connect to the VPN, the client has to get authenticated, okay? Suppose you want to connect to the VPN server, so you will have to get authenticated using password or certificate. When you are authenticated, then only this tunnel is created, okay? This tunnel works. Now in order to use the VPN, there are various implementations of it. One open source implementation is OpenVPN, okay? So OpenVPN is the open source software that implements the VPN, okay? And this runs on your server and it has also a client that runs at your end. Now this software is used by majorly all the VPN service providers so that you can access your access internet via your local machine, okay? So VPN has a role to extend your local network so that you can access it remotely, okay? and it has also the role that you can access the internet anonymously, for example. Okay. So, I hope you must have now understood that what is a VPN and how it is used in our internet. Okay. So, I will meet you in the next video. Take care.